This is the SAP Developer News for March 27th, 2025.
I've had many roles in my working life in the SAP technical ecosphere. One of those roles was as an SAP Enterprise Architect. So when I saw Stefan highlight a new learning journey all about SAP Enterprise Architecture, my interest was piqued. As Stefan highlights, it's a course that's beginner-friendly and covers everything you need to get started with SAP Enterprise Architecture, including what the role entails, fundamentals, key concepts, tools, frameworks, and so on, plus a look at SAP's reference architecture. The course is free, so what are you waiting for? Happy learning.
Hey ABAP developers, you might have come across GoodToKnow YouTube Shorts on ABAP Cloud, which we publish every Friday since the beginning of this year. So far, we have covered 12 videos and there are many more to come. We are covering in two segments. Firstly, about ABAP development tools. If you're new to ADT, these tips and tricks will definitely help you into smooth transitioning into ADT. Secondly, some good facts and points about ABAP Cleaner. You can configure ABAP Cleaner, which is a tool intended to automate as much as possible with respect to ABAP code style. The link to the playlist is in the description. Check it out and do let us know what you think.
It's me again, DJ. This time, though, standing in for Vitaly, my good friend and colleague, because this item is all about SAP HANA Cloud. So there's always innovation in that space. And to mark the end of March, Thomas Hammer has published a blog post highlighting what's new in the SAP HANA Cloud Q1 2025 release. And my goodness me, it's massive. It's a bumper edition. So I thought I'd take some time to summarize the details of the Q1 release so you know what you have to look forward to. You can get an overview of the main ones in a 4-minute video that Thomas links from his blog post, but the detailed breakdown you can get from the blog post itself. So Thomas divides up the new features into different sections, the first one being administration and service management. Basically, there is improved instance management and generation, and there's also better issue management and diagnosis through the automatic summarization of issues. In the machine learning and predictive analytics area, there are facilities to improve machine learning accuracy. That's through better regression model building and unified classification. There's also support for text extraction from binary files, such as PDF, for example. And there's also a new generative AI toolkit with lots of new features. In the multi-model data processing arena, there's now native support for the resource description framework, RDF, and therefore also Sparkle, as well as SQL. There's better maximum flow graph problem support. There's also an addition of a new alter vector index statement, which means you can keep your indices up to date, which is great for performance. And there's also support for vector data storage using the native storage extension. In the area of graphical view modeling, there are better facilities for cleaning up intermediate data previews. There's a new facility for using tables, views, or functions to derive multiple values from input data. There's a new execution hint in the area of currency conversion performance and a new vector embedding function. There's also, last but not least, the ability to target a specific database release when creating calculation views. Beyond all that, there's a ton of innovations also in SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake. There's expanded data availability, data center rather, availability for SAP HANA Cloud, and lots of improvements in the area generally of database application development. This was just the briefest of brief summaries. I hope I've done Thomas's blog post justice. I encourage you strongly to go and check out Thomas's blog post we've put the link in the description to this news item. It's got a ton of details on everything I've mentioned and lots more, plus links to further material. So check out Thomas's blog post and see you next time.
Hola, SAP developers. I got some exciting news to share with you. In cloud integration, you can now configure your JMS queues to either exclusive or non-exclusive access types, meaning that we now have exactly once-in-order processing for JMS. With the non-exclusive access type, messages are processed concurrently. With the exclusive access type, messages are processed sequentially by a single consumer and in the order in which they are received. I'm including a link to the documentation in the description. Also, there's a new generative AI feature available in cloud integration. It was announced at SAP TechEd last year. In essence, we're now able to optimize our Groovy scripts. The optimized script functionality will generate a report which will give you a general assessment of the script. It will also recommend some changes, if applicable, and even provide you with an improved script. Remember that to use this new feature, you will need to have enabled the GenAI-based features in your tenant. Now let's talk a bit about connectivity. There's a new version of Cloud Connector available. Version 2.18, apart from a couple of bug fixes, there are quite a few enhancements. For example, it now supports Windows Server 2025. There's also support for automatic renewal of the sub-account certificate. It introduces a new centralized management of email and LDAP server trust stores. There's a new troubleshooting section to help you diagnose problems within the Cloud Connector, and much more. Make sure to check out the release notes link that's included in the description. Ciao.